Shalom to everyone. We're learning today Zera Shimshon Parashat Hukat. Today's learning should be Leilu Nishmat, my dear student. Rafael Moshe ben Devorah, Ruach HaShem Tenichenu Bagan Eden. And HaShem should give good news, Besorot Tovot, to everyone. We should have always good news. All the unthinkable things that are happening in the community, HaShem should cool it all down, and we should be always in a good occasions. Leilu Nishmat Yosef ben Sarah and
Avraham ben Biti.
Thank you everyone for coming. Refuah Shlema Avraham Chaim ben Yocheved.
Refuah Shlema David ben Osnat.
וגם רפואה שלמה דוד בן אסנת.
וגם דור בדיוק.
גם דור בדיוק. תור משה בן בן בלור.
אליהו בן עדינה.
גם אליהו בן עדינה. בשורות טובות אברהם בית בגלל רפואה שלמה. And we should have always good news. All our kids that are graduating today, they should become big talmidei chachamim. וכן יהי רצון ונאמר אמן. Parashat Hukat. In the Sefer Zera Shimshon, number Yud Bet 12, quotes a story from Gemara Brachot in page 33a, chapter 5. Maaseh Bemakom Echad. A story happened how in one place, Shaya Bo Arud. It was a dangerous snake. V'aya mazik et abriyot. This snake was biting people and would kill them. As you remember, a few days ago, somebody genius was sending to people how big anaconda snake, python. People send it to everywhere. How eight women, this woman was missing, and they found in the snake. Today we will see, it's interesting, Zera Shimshon always quotes things that happen during the week. Today we will see what usually happened to that python, woman. What's the story, what's going on here? מעשה במקום אחד שהיה בו ערוד והיה מזיק את הבריות. There was a snake, it would bite people and kill people. באו והודיעו לרבי חנינא בן דוסא. They came and they said to רבי חנינא בן דוסא, they said, Rabbi, he's sitting in bed midrash learning, רבי חנינא בן דוסא, and they said, Rabbi, there is a dangerous snake on 108th Street. אמר להם, הראוני את הורכורו. Show me his hole. Where is the house? Where is this coming out from? I want to know where is the house of that snake. They showed him. He came there, put his leg there. Snake says, Shechianu, come out and bite Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa. The law of this snake is, whoever comes closer first to the water, if snake goes first to the water, person dies. Person goes to the water, snake dies. So there was a stone, rock, Midrash says. He looked at the rock, rock became water. He put his leg there, that snake came out and was lying dead. He put his leg by the hole, his heel. Yatzav unshacho umet ha'arut. The snake bites him, and instead of him passing away, snake dies. Amar lahem, he picked up the snake, put it on his shoulder. You know, snake is heavy. It looks like very small, very light. It's full of muscles and meat. It's heavy piece. So he picks it up on his shoulder, comes to the yeshiva, throws on the table. Meanwhile, they're learning Gemara, Baba Kama, Bab Mitzia, yeah? Eruvin, he says, guys, I have a shiur for you. What happened? Re'u, look, She'ena arud memit. It's not the snake that kills. Ela achet memit. But the sin that kills. Veiksha Marsha. Marsha is asking a question. Eich samach al hanes. Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa says, nobody dies. No snake kills anybody. People die from sin. If let's say that person, India, I don't know where is it, India, Thailand, I don't know where is it. If she wouldn't sin, snake wouldn't be able to swallow her. Snake doesn't kill, sin kills. Okay, fine, I understand this. Second thing, Maharsha is asking, how can you put yourself under the power of the miracles? My father used to say, three things be careful. You fought with somebody. Don't tell him, let's go outside, I want to see you face to face. Why? Don't trust in yourself. You're putting your life in danger. And what? You're depending on a miracle? Don't depend on a miracle. Second thing, you see the wall is falling down, about to fall. They say, caution, don't pass by this. Say, don't worry, I'm going to say, Shema Yisrael, I'll pass, everything will be okay. It will not be okay, it's going to collapse on you. Don't put yourself under the danger depending on a miracle. The third one, you don't know how to swim. You don't know how to swim by going to the water. Everything will be fine. Will not be fine, it's an ocean here. Don't swim, especially now, summer. Don't go to swim. You don't know how to swim, don't go to the water. Many people who knew how to swim didn't return. Why are you going to the water? So there's three things. Don't depend on miracles. Now, how Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa put his leg into the hole of the snake. Snake comes out, bites him. And what is he doing? Ah, miracles. I'm okay. Snake dies, he picks it up, comes to the yeshiva. Fine. You give a good point. Sin doesn't kill. Snake kills. But what are you going to do with the miracles? How can you depend on a miracle? How can you put your leg in front of that dangerous snake? Dangerous. Guys, please, if tomorrow you hear 180 scorpion running, don't say I'm going to put my leg, scorpion is going to die. Don't put your leg in these dangers, guys. Please, please. Please. Miracles don't happen with everybody. You have to be Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa. Ula aniyut da'ati nir'eh. The end zakusha. Really? How did Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa put himself by on a miracle, depending on a miracle? It's not a question. Why? Sha'arei derech HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is a way for HaShem. La'asot le'tzadikim nes betoch nes. HaShem makes miracles for tzadikim. HaShem has certain way for tzadikim. He does miracle in the miracle. De kishe ose lahem nes echad, yesh lahem liftoch gam al nes sheni. When HaShem makes a miracle, you should depend on HaShem. He's going to make me second miracle as well. Miracle in the miracles. Exactly. It reduces merit, so what happens here? How can Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa depend on a miracle? And what? HaShem does you a miracle, so next time you should depend on a miracle. Ah, HaShem will do it. We know so many books, they say don't depend on miracles. HaShem takes your reward away, your mitzvot away, so what happens here? כמו דוד ומרדכי שניתן להם רמז וחשוב. השם gave them hint, but they near ears. והואיל שמצינו דעזי דלבי חנינה ואין דוסה. So what happened? In גמר במציא, chapter 9, page 106a, גמר במציא says, there were goats of רבי חנינה ואין דוסה. They went a little bit into the forest and they were bears. Usually what eats what? Bear eats goat or goat eats bear? What happens? Bear eats goat, right? Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa's goats, HaShem made the miracles. They went on the bear, sticked into the horn, pick it up. Came to Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa with the horns, bears on top. And they threw it on the floor. He said, woohoo! If Hashem made me such a big miracle that my goats were able to knock down the bears, I could go further and trust in miracles from now on. And therefore he puts his leg on the hole of the snake. Why? Because his goats destroyed bears. Let's go now inside. They brought bears in the horns. They have a Nisa Rabbah. It's a great miracle. A bear lost war to the goats. Goat beat up the bear. And not only beat up, pokes hole with the horn and carries him in the horns. Over there, bigger miracle, he depended. Here is a smaller miracle. He depended for sure. Why? Because he is worthy for it. You want to ask a question? Ask this question. What is the intention of Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa? One second. Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa says, the snake doesn't kill. Who kills? What kills? Sin kills. What is that trying to teach you? If you already try to do everything okay with your car, and then you get ticket. Why you got ticket? Because if you already got the ticket, it means you did certain sin. If you do everything right and you still get a problem, then it's your sin caused it. The snake doesn't kill. Sin kills. Person just doesn't fall some stump. If you fall, it means there's something behind it. Investigation should not be done on the physical world. It has to be done in the spiritual world. The spiritual world shines the light into the physical world. But everything starts from the spiritual world, not from the physical world. So Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa puts his physical leg on the physical snake to show in my spiritual world there's no holes there. Once there's no hole, there's no black spot of the Avera, I have nothing to be worried about. The snake will not be able to grab me, I don't have a hole. And again, you tell me snake just comes by itself and bites? Why snake? Why snake? Look what it says in Kohelet, Yud Aleph. Im yashuch anachash b'lo lachash. Do you really think snake bites without having a lachash? Do you know snake has an ear, right? In the ear, Hashem says, go bite this guy. There's a Ahmadinejad over there. Go get him. Snake goes? Ahmad, no. Ahmadini, no. Ahmadinejad, yes. Then snake bites him. Why? Because Hashem whispers into the ear of the snake, go get this guy. Do you really think snake bites without whispering? Nashuch below lachash.
But that's what happened to Nachash with Hava. He started whispering in the ear.
Hashem, after that, gave 10 punishments to the snake. And one of the punishments says, you will have no right to bite anyone unless I give you permission, Hashem says. And people who have protecting Lashon Hara, never in the world snake will bite them. Wow. Never in the world. Snake, why? Snake bites only people with Lashon Hara problems. Why? Because snake's job was Lashon Hara. So anyone speaks Lashon Hara, in the Gemara time, they say what? Put sand in his mouth. Why? Because Hashem cursed snake after he spoke Lashon Hara. Everywhere you go, everything you eat will have a taste of the scent. So anyone speaks Lashon Hara, Gemara says, send in his mouth. Like Eov, spoke complaints to Hashem. Hashem said, send his mouth. Why? Spoke like snake. Lashon hara. Dahainu. Shanachash eno noshech ela lemi shenigzar alav milmala. Snake never bites unless there is a signal comes from the above. Shamay. Hashem says, him. La'alinu la'alechem. My father used to say, if scorpion bites you, you scream, yell. If snake bites you, you sit quiet. Why? People will say, you're a snake. You speak Lashon Hara about people. This is why snake bites you. This is why my father used to say, snake bites you, you don't scream. Something else bites you, you yell. Snake, you quiet. I don't know where my father used to get this such an interesting rhetoric. One statement says the whole community would laugh. One statement. Sometimes I say 3 hour things. Once there was Lavaya, the speaker came, he thought I'm gonna get $100 today for speaking, you know. So the owner says, come over here. You see how many people sitting here, make them cry, I'll give you $1,000. So he goes, he starts remembering the most terrible things, incidents that happened in the Torah, starting from Tisha B'Av, Yudzayim B'Tammuz, nothing helps. He sees nobody's crying. He's like 40 minutes talking, not even one tear from the community. He looks at the owner and says, listen, if I open sink and water doesn't come out, what should I do? The water is not there, what do you want from me? I try to do whatever, no tear comes out from people. What do you want from me? Can't help. Okay, you guys don't get it, fine. Ve'im ken, ma'osif beze. And if snake will not bite unless it comes from Shamayim, what Rabbi Chanina ben Dos tried to say here? He puts his leg, snake doesn't bite. Of course, it's not going to bite, it's tzaddik. Snake bites only how? When there's sign from Shamayim. Okay, fine. Snake doesn't kill, what kills? Sin kills. Matzore chaya sheimut arut halo haya dai shelo inashech. Inashchenu. 1 second. What kills? Sin kills. Snake kills? No. So Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa put his leg there, right? Put his leg there? Yeah, does he have sin?
No.
So what should happen?
Snake should not bite.
Snake should not bite. And snake should not die. If snake doesn't kill, so why should snake die? Do you make sense to you? Does snake kills? No. What kills? Sin kills. If snake didn't kill Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa because it doesn't have sin, why should snake die?
Because he bit him without Hashem's permission. No, Hashem whispered in his ear.
To do what?
To bite.
Why?
No, I'm sorry, the other person.
Yeah, but why did snake bite Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa?
That's a good question. Why did he bite? And nothing happened.
Exactly, nothing happened.
Cross the territory.
If nothing happened to Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa, why should snake die?
Because he
beat Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa, huh?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, snake doesn't have brain. Would have brain. I understand. I could complain to him. Hey, my friend, what are you doing? Who are you biting? My name is Abba. No, you put your brain in place. And here, snake bites Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa. What do we say to him? Why should snake die? Good question or no?
Yeah.
It's the same as a mouse. What's the answer?
I don't know yet. I'm gone. אבל עכשיו שאנו רואים שזה הערות, and now we see that this is the snake שבא שם כדי להזיק הבריות. The snake came, why? Hashem sent, said go to Iraq and do your job. So snake came to do his job. דשמע מינה ששלחו אותו מן השמיים. Hashem sent this snake to the city of where Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa is, from Shamayim. Ve'alach nami lishoch l'Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa atzmo. And snake came also to go and bite Rabbi Chanina ben Dosa. If no, he wouldn't bite. Ve'lo day shelo asa lo shum nezek. Not only snake didn't do nothing to him, ele adrava met arut. But even opposite, snake died. The Shema Amina comes out. She'af ha'yetzerera. הנושך את האדם כדי להחתיאו, and mamash benishichazo. If snake bites you, snake is who? Yetzer ha? Ra. Yetzer ha is the first snake, right? Haman is snake. Snake is Yetzer hara. Haman was Yetzer hara. He wants to destroy the whole Jewish nation, right? So if Yetzer hara comes to bite you, to make you sin, don't worry. There's nothing there in it. Ela ha'adam yachol li'natzel mimenu ule'orgo. You could protect yourself back from Yetzer hara and kill it. If I would tell you this in June, during the month of January, February, it's much easier. Now, eye seasons. Tammuz, right eye. Av, left eye. Tammuz is letter Chet, and Av is letter Tet. Comes out the word Chet. What's Chet? Sin. These months are months of sinning. If we protect our eyes, Yetzer will come to do, make us more sin, even though we're already about to sin, because Yetzer is biting us. Still don't worry. Hold yourself back, make teshuvah, kill Yetzer. Who's teaching us this? Rabbi Hanina?
Mendoza.
He says, you see snake bite me? Even Yetzer bites you. Even though you already did mistake, even though you went somewhere wrong, still stop yourself. Make teshuva, break it, destroy it.
So he did teshuva?
Huh?
He did teshuva?
He
was deserving of what he has.
Rabbi Hanina ben Dosa doesn't need to do teshuva, he's teaching us a lesson. He's coming from where he came from, Bet Midrash. What does that mean? When you learn Torah, do you have a veranu?
So how does things still matter?
Huh? To teach you a lesson! Even if it's a Sahara bites you, don't be afraid.
But was he waiting for the miracle to happen?
Was he waiting for a miracle? You tell me.
Yeah,
he was. He? Of course he was waiting. You know why? Because he had greater miracle before. And Tzaddik gets from HaShem miracle in the miracle.
Miracle after miracle, no?
Miracle after miracle. HaShem makes you great miracle to let you know something small come up, I'll make you miracle as well.
I would learn, even if you come from a big one, you still need to
You're right, Rabbi Gabriel. But you know what Lambam says? The best teshuva ever in the world is learning Torah. There's nothing like learning Torah. As soon as you count the seed learning Torah, I mean, of course, person should work on his midot. But as soon as you come to learn Torah, that's the best teshuva you can get in the world. Some people do teshuva all day long in shul. Instead of sitting and learning, they're doing, I don't know what they're doing. But person should sit and learn. When a person learns Torah, the best Shua ever. Kmo shematzinu beDavid. Even though Yetzer hara bites you, you still could take it and break it. How do we know? As we found by David HaMelech. In Tehillim Kuf Tet 109, the phrase Chav Hei 25. Velibi chalal bekilbi. What makes you desire things? Your heart. He says, my heart is dead inside me. Like empty. There's nothing there for my heart. Why? Because I made my heart work so hard not to desire wrong things. Libi halal bekidbi. My Yetzer hara in me is dead.
That's good.
Of course. I mean, it doesn't come overnight. When a person works out through Yetzer hara to put the Yetzer hara in the place for years, then already he gets used to it. Yetzer hara dies out, leaves him alone, says, listen, there's nothing for me to start up with you.
I heard that six years, 7 years.
Huh?
6 years.
What? For how long Yetzer hara stays away?
5.
What? He's...
And then after that, he leaves you alone.
Once he's entering to the level of being tzaddik shalem, for life, Yetzer hara doesn't come back to him. Ve'amru Chazal, huh? I'll tell you one thing. When a person is trying to go on top of the medicine, nah. How do you call that tall building? Twin tower. When a person is going to that twin tower on top, meanwhile he's on 50th floor, he's holding on the rope, he's still good. grab. But once it's on the roof, very easy to fall from there. It's much easier to fall from roof than from the 30th, 40th floor. Why? Because anything wrong you do, you go fall, you go down. Same thing. When person is being tzaddik shalem and the process, he makes small mistakes, yes, small mistakes that are acceptable. Why? Because it's not completed. But once it's complete, then he does. He falls right away down. The bigger tzaddik you are, the bigger fall could be, chas v'shalom. So therefore, the more you are tzaddik, the more you have to work hard not to fall from that.
So
David HaMelech had more tests than the regular person, yes?
Sorry, how come HaShem rises you up so high? And then
you could just
sometimes, I'm not saying all the time, but it happens.
When person rises up from his midot, he has now harder tests. If he holds his test, he stays on his level. If he doesn't, he falls down. But does it mean that he's failure for life?
No.
Or it means once you could reach up there, you still could reach up there again. But this time should stay longer. She David Hargol Yetzerara, because David HaMelech killed his Yetzerara, Vach Yamrei, and therefore we say, Beperekama de Kiddushin, in the first chapter in Gemara Kiddushin, page 30b, Ve'im ata roce, ata timshol bo. If you want your Yetzer Hara, you will be ruling over. Not Yetzer Hara ruling over you, but you rule your Yetzer Hara. With one simple story, I will conclude. Ben Ish Chai brings a beautiful mashal in Agadah Shel Pesach. And this mashal worth a life to listen to. One man, he was sitting on his donkey. He was sitting on his donkey and he was going from the forest to home. And he sees on the floor a beggar sitting and crying without feet. He says, what do you want? He says, please do me a favor. Put me in your chariot. So the owner felt bad. He picks up the man without legs, put him on the chariot. As they were riding, he says, I'm sitting all the way in the back. I never sat in the front row. He stopped the chariot. He put him in the front row. He started going further. He's going to start crying. He says, I never sat on the donkey itself because I have no legs. Nobody have pity on me. So he felt bad. He put him in the back. He says, I never sit in the front. I said, fine, here, sit in the front. As they're going now, he's crying here, so I don't understand. You were there, I picked you up, you're back in front now. What do you want? What are you crying for? I never was holding a rope. And the owner gives him, man, please, hold the rope. And now they enter to the city. They enter to the city, this guy's screaming, guys, help! I'm being robbed. So what do you mean, being robbed? He says, this guy sees that I have no legs. He wants to steal from me my donkey, my horse, my chariot, my everything. That says, you crazy? I had mercy on you. He says, guys, this guy is crazy. Help me from him. I have no legs. He's robbing me. Look, he's so crazy. Anything I say, he says mine. Whose chariot is mine? Whose horse is mine? Whose rope is mine? See, this guy's crazy. He sees I have no legs. He wants to abuse me. He's robbing me. They took him to the court. Judge said, no, stop listening to him. No, what's your story? He says, I saw this guy on the floor. I felt bad. I put him in the back, then front, then down the horse. And then he said, I want to sit in front. I made him sit in front. Then the judge says, who gave him rope? He says, I did. He says, crazy. You did so much good. Why would you give him rope? Once you made him rule over your chariot, what do you want me to do now? How can I help you? You gave it to him yourself. The rope is mine and your neshama. If you give your neshama to be ruled over by Yetzer Hara, follow Yetzer Hara, how do you want to be protected? This is what Ben Ishchai is asking. This is what Gemara Kiddushin, page 30b says. V'im ata rotze, ata timshol bo. If you want, you will rule your Yetzer Hara, and not Yetzer Hara rules you. So let's see if our summer will be in the head or will be in the tail. The whole Rosh Hashanah, Sheniyel Rosh Lelosanah, we prayed, HaShem, make me to be a head and not a tail. For who? For Yetzer Hara. When is this visible? If we had a tail, summer. HaShem should keep us as a head rule al yitzhara and not opposite, grow in learning in kiddushah v'cheni ratzon v'naman amen.